Hey guys, this is Mike from BTech Reviews here, and today we take a look at and unbox the TicWatch Pro 3. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to take a look at the TicWatch Pro 3 Ultra GPS wearable watch. Now this is a Wear OS by Google Android watch. And again, I had never really heard about the brand, the TicWatch Pro 3, but again, they did reach out to me, and the makers of this, the brand is called Mobvoi, if I'm not correct on that. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Mobvoi. And again, I'm going to post up the affiliate link so you guys can check this in the description down below. Currently, this actually retails on Amazon for $299. And again, if you guys are interested in something or an alternative to the actual... I guess the Samsung watch, and there's some other watches out there that you can buy that are compatible. But apparently this watch is compatible with iPhone as well, although you're not going to get all the features that you would get on Android Wear, right? But it says it comes with a Qualcomm Snapdragon Wear 4100 platform. Let's see, it says IHB, AFIB, detection and fatigue assessment, military standard 810G, and built-in GPS, which is pretty cool. Let's take a look back here really quick. Okay, on the back it says... Again, the Qualcomm Snapdragon 4100 platform, military standard, up to 72 hours of battery life in smart mode and 45 days on essential mode. So that's actually relatively good compared to my Apple Watch. My Apple Watch gets maybe about a day and a half, you know, less than 48 hours on a full battery. 20 plus professional workout modes. It is waterproof and swim wearable, so you can actually wear this if you jump into the pool. It's got Google Assistant activated, built-in GPS, dual display with customized colorful backlight, and a high-density heart rate monitor and stress and sleep tracking as well. So a lot of these features, of course, you know, already are in other smartwatches, right? But again, this smartwatch, again, with for the $299 price range, you know, again, you know, let's see if the hype is worth it, you know what I mean? So again, it comes with a nice box here. Again, shout out to the people that sent this out to me. And again, excuse the ugly lighting right here in my house. But anywho, it does come with the instruction manual. Again, TicWatch Pro 3 Quick Guide. And again, it looks like it can come with, there's a GPS version and then there's a 4G version. And it just looks like it does come with, again, instructions on how to use the watch. But let's get this thing going. I think you guys aren't here to... hear me ramble, right? You guys are actually here to see the watch as we take a look here. So, well, I mean, again, there we go. Let me change the lighting on that. This watch is pretty nice looking, I'm not gonna lie. Looks very high quality, and just next to the picture over here, again, it does look pretty nice. So again, I want to just pull this out. Let's see what comes inside the box really quick with the watch. It looks like it does come with some sort of I guess charging cable, which this one, it seems to come with like a two-prong cable, right? Which again, it's not too bad. It's USB-A on the other end, so that's pretty cool. So if you have any type of charger, you can just connect it to there. It does not come with a power brick though, so I guess it comes with the intention that you guys know that it's not going to come with something like that. So again, it looks like it is going to also come with this, which again, instruction manual on what to do as far as, you know, what apps to download, etc. So most likely you do have to download an app to get this to work. So I'm going to just leave that in there for now. Let's see what else comes in the box. Just regulatory information here and your little packet to avoid moisture. So let's go ahead and put this back over here. So again, very nice looking watch, I'm not gonna lie. Like, there you go. I'm sorry, my phone seems to be auto focusing a lot here. But for the most part, super shiny from the front. It looks nice. It feels very good in the hand. Let me go ahead and pull this out really quick. The band looks very nice also. I don't know if this is a watch where you can actually like change out the band. I'm over here already scratching the faceplate over here. But let's try to get this taken off really quick just so that we can finally remove this over here. So again, here's the watch itself. And very nice looking watch, very nice build, I'm not going to lie. Here's the back of the watch. So again, these little sensors will track your monitor, track your heart rate, your blood pressure most likely. And it says UKCA on the back, so I don't know if this is made in the UK maybe, or in Canada perhaps. Let's see if turning it on does anything. Holding down this button, there's two actual button. So that first one didn't work. Let's try the second one. And I might actually have to charge this or set it up to charge maybe. A lot of the times, like with these smartwatches, you actually have to get them plugged in first to get them turned on. So let me go ahead and try that with this watch over here really quick. Let's see how the magnets work really quick. Again, pretty simple. It clamps in really quick. And luckily for me, I do have a... Luckily for me, I do have a charging dock right here next to me. So I can actually just plug this in. Let's see if I can get that going here. Let's see if that does anything. Okay, I did feel a vibration on the actual device. So there we go. There it is. Tick watch. Let's put this in the background. Thumbnail. But anyways, let's see if I can get this watch set up, guys. It looks like it does have a full battery already. So let me see if I can get the setup, and then we'll get you going. All right, so it looks like I finally got the watch going, and I turned off that light in the background because I think that light was actually interfering with the actual like brightness on the camera. I am filming on a cell phone, by the way. I used to film on a DSLR, but now I just decided to start filming again on my cell phone, so hopefully that works. So it says wear Android watch, and again, I'm assuming that I'm going to have to probably scan this QR code here or something like that. It says tap to begin. All right, let's do English. Of course, I am American, an American citizen. So it says notice of health warnings or etc. So I'm assuming you just have to read through that and then go ahead and scroll down. And it says on your phone, download Wear OS by Google. So I'm actually going to be pairing this with the Pixel 6 Pro over here. So again, let's jump into that really quick. Let's go ahead and put this down. Wear OS by Google. So let's go ahead and type this in. And again, this is just if you were to set this up personally yourself. Wear OS by Google. So there it is. Wear. Let's go ahead and install it. And then it says download and open. So once I download, I'm going to go ahead and open the actual app here. So let's go ahead. And luckily, I have some pretty fast internet here. So once we get that going, let's go ahead and open it up. So let's see, it does say start setup. So let me just go ahead and agree here. And again, this is just for first time users, for someone that does not know how to do this. And this is the first time I actually have a Wear OS compatible watch, okay? You just have to agree here. So it says connect with your watch. Tap your watch name when it appears in the list. So here you go. Looks like the watch does pop up on the list. TicWatch 3 Pro Ultra. So let's go ahead and see if we can get that going over here. And again, I'll go ahead and allow access to my contacts and my history here. So let me go ahead and just do that really quick while that's going. So it says connected, and it's syncing, again, my contacts and information over here with this specific device. Now let's go ahead and check that out. So very nice watch, guys. Let's go ahead and put this thing on. And again, I would be using this as if it was just a regular watch for me. So let's see. I do have a little bit of a skinny wrist here, guys. So bear with me while I get this turned on, and I will go ahead and put my phone over here. But I usually put phones on my left wrist over here. Now some people might use their right wrist. But again, pretty nice. Let's continue to get the setup though. All right, so I am back, and I am testing, I guess, what you would call the face plates on here, you know, because again, you can change these, which is pretty cool. Again, I don't know how it works exactly. Like, I feel like this is like the standby mode, right? But you can actually like change the faces of the actual watch itself. Let's see if I can go home here. There you go. So there's one. Let me go to another one. Let's see if that works. And again, you can do this directly from your device with the Wear OS app over here. Okay, let's just go ahead and say yes over here. And they do have more face plates, so if I wanted to, I can make it look like a little more fancy, which I think is pretty cool. Like, you know, let's see. I think that one looks legit, by the way, which is pretty cool. You know, a lot of people want something more simple, though. Like, let's change it to that. Let's tap it. See if double tap works. So there you go. So that looks pretty cool. And as you can see here, it does have information like your no upcoming events. It has like information like the battery percentage on the watch, how many steps you've had, etc. like that. So pretty cool. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, you know, again with this on standby mode, again, it just kind of sits like that, which is pretty cool. Makes me want to take the watch off really quick, actually. But no, I want to see if the heart rate monitor works really quick, I guess. So let's try to navigate through this watch really quick. So let's see. So what is this? Tick Coach. It says Tick Coach evaluates your authentic capacity using your personal data. Exercise. Okay, let's go ahead and click the check mark. Please enter your info. So it's gonna ask you if you are a male or female. I'll go ahead and put a male. Let's see, for those that want to know how old I am. I was born. Ooh, hold on, let's see. No, let's not go that far. Screen is not as sensitive as I want it to be, but it does have a screen cover on it, so there's that. I was born in 86. I'm about 5'9". Let's go with 5'9". Let's go with 160 pounds in weight. I used to weigh like 140 like a year or two ago. I don't know. All that Taco Bell and pizza over the during the pandemic, you know what I mean? There we go. Let's stay with 160. Exercise goal no set for now. Let's just not set it for now. So, okay, hold on. Let's see if I can get out of here really quick. So here are the different functions of the watch here. And again, you know, you have tick exercise, tick pulse. Let's see what's going on with my pulse. Again, if you see that it is high, then it's probably because I just ate a bunch of pizza right now. It says almost done. Login, Mavoy ID. Can we skip that? So let's see what this looks like. Just checking my heart rate really quick. And I am gonna have to change the settings on this, so keep that in mind. But it looks like my resting heart rate right now is 90. And again, let's see. Let's try to go back here. 82. It's dropping, as you can see here. So pretty cool. I mean, again, it's telling me the temperature outside right now. It's already got the sync synced up how cold it is. Calendar events. So for the most part, let's see. Let's see what the different swipe gestures goes to. So it's pretty interesting, guys. I really like it so far. You know, you can set up, you know, Google Pay with this as well, which is pretty awesome. Let's take a look at that. About to ring phone, so it's gonna ring my phone because I lost my device. So if I'm wearing the watch and I can't find my device, there's my actual phone right there. That's pretty cool. Let's take a look again. Let's see. Let's turn on the mute button. Do not disturb mode, right? Let's see what swiping up here. What I really want to do is see if I can just change the brightness of the actual watch, right? So like display, watch face, adjust brightness. So I think that, can I turn off auto? There you go. The fact that you can turn on and off auto is pretty cool because that's going to save you battery life, right? There you go. I think that one is pretty okay. Let's see if I can go back. There we go. Okay, and then let's set up sounds here. So you can set up sounds, ringer volume, also vibrate for calls. So it's got a, you know, again, and watch Wear OS seems to be very simple and basic. And it's, you know, again, I've never used it. I do have an Apple Watch, but again, this does. You know, this is Android's version basically. So just trying to figure out like the gesturing on this is a little complicated though. Compared to like my Umadigi smartwatches, it's not super easy to use, but I mean, you know, again, it does give you information like gestures, connectivity, accessibility, general personalization, storage. And I might have to make an update just to see how long the battery does last on this watch, guys. And again, let's change the face one more time. Let's see. What face could I use, guys? What face do you guys like over here? I just really like the customability of it, honestly. So like, if I wanted to change it, there's the new face, and it looks just pretty awesome. Like I just love how you have all of these options as far as like the face plates, right? And it's pretty cool. Kind of like this one, but you know what? This was the default one, right? This is the default one that's on the actual screen. So really not bad. to take exercise on, but yada yada yada. So I'm getting notifications over here. But anywho, guys, you know, this was just a quick unboxing and overview of the TicWatch Pro 3 GPS. Again, I will go ahead and post up a link in the description down below so you guys can check that out. And just so you guys know, quality-wise, this watch feels very durable and it feels very tough. And it's not a cheap watch, I can tell you that much. Like, compared to other smartwatches that I've used, it's got a good feel as far as how heavy it is. It's definitely not heavy at all on the wrist. You know, it's got that standby mode where, again, it looks like it just kind of dims and you can still kind of see the time on the watch. You know, and again, if you know, gesture movements will allow it to pick up and it'll give you more information like that. You know, again, if you want to check your heart rate, you know, all you have to do is just swipe to the right. And it'll give you more information as far as that, checking your heart rate and all that. Check, you know, doing like distance. It'll track steps. It'll do a lot of different things, which is pretty cool in my opinion, right? So again, guys, this is Mike from B-Tech Reviews signing off. Again, I might do an update video. This is just a quick, really, really quick overview video and unboxing of this device. But again, I just really appreciate you guys watching this. If you guys like the video, don't forget to smash the like button. If you guys like the channel, don't forget to subscribe. And again, we will see you next time. Again, check the link in the description below so you can check this watch out. Again, Mike signing off. We'll see y'all next time.